At first, this video was supposed to be covering all the different mediums, but while editing, I realized that it is too long, so I have thought of splitting it up into three different videos to keep it short, crisp, and also interesting. So please don't mind my abrupt beginning.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you don't know me, my name is Sanvi, and today's video is going to be all about different art supplies for beginner watercolor artists. These are all the basic supplies which you can start with, and I have also kept the budget in mind. So I'm super excited for you guys to know all the things which I have to say. So without any further ado now, let's start. So I'm gonna start with all the things you need if you wanna start watercolors. First, of course, the most important is what watercolor paints would you want to use? So right here, I have the Camlin Artist Grade watercolors. To be true, if you're starting out, I would rather just take the artist grade by paying like a few, I think like 100 or so extra, and get the artist grade rather than the normal student grade, because they are not at all pigmented. But these artist grades are like amazing, and they're still lasting me. Just a few colors are almost about to get over, but I still love using them, and I think I would highly recommend you guys go for artist grade rather than student grade. But also, if you don't want to use this, you can also use the Faber-Castell ones. So I just bought these like last year during the lockdown, because most of my colors were running out, so I needed something else. So I love using also the Faber-Castell, and they're really great for beginners. I put all my favorite colors from like the Camlin and also the Faber-Castell into a palette, which is super messy, but I keep just renewing it with all my other shades. And I also mixed a few shades like pastels, which I like using. And again, this palette is I think 2 to 3 years old, but I just love having all my colors right here and don't need to mix all the colors again. Next up is brushes. So to be true, you can just start out with any brush. I've been just using these Camlin brushes or even the Faber-Castell ones and another type of Faber-Castell. So I'll keep putting up like pictures of the brushes I'm talking if you're not able to get them. These are just basic and you can start out with them. This is perfectly fine. And last but not the least, of course, paper is super important, and that's the most important rather than also the paints and brushes. So let's talk about papers. We can start out with this most famous paper brand. It's a little coming out, but okay. This is a Chitrapat watercolor paper. It's very popular, and also I just love using this. It has a lot of texture and great for skies and literally a lot of stuff. So this is a huge one because I need it a little bigger size, but there are different sizes which you can find. This is I think the rough. This is much better and great for beginners. If you want like a cold press, Canson is also nice. I like using Canson, but I prefer it more for lettering, but Canson is also nice. You can also try Lustro in Artist Watercolor Paper Hot Press. This has 25% cotton, and this is hot press, and this is the same thing in cold press in A4. These are my go-to paper. I would highly recommend the Chitrapat or Canson. These are the two which I love a lot. Something which is super duper important to have while doing watercolors is to have masking tape to get those crisp borders which you see maybe on Instagrams. So this is how they get. Just put the tape on the borders. It will also make sure that your paper is not moving while painting. You can get this in a normal hardware store, but I can also link it up for you guys in the description. It's not too harsh or too strong, so it's not probably gonna peel off your paper, but also if it does, just try to make sure that you're peeling it a little slowly and at an angle so that you don't get the paper along with the tape while removing it. So super duper handy and a must have for watercolor listeners. I hope you guys found this helpful. If you do like this type of video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and also share it with the people who are really into art. And maybe this could be a gift guide for you, because the holiday season is coming up, so you can definitely make a hamper out of all the things which the person wants to try and give it to them. So super helpful. I'll see you guys pretty soon. Till then, bye.